hadn't been forgotten, I Joe. I've been married a long time ago. Where did you come from? Where did you go? Where did you come from, Cotton Eye Joe? If it hadn't been forgotten, I Joe. I've been married a long time ago. Where did you come from? Where did you go? Where did you come from, Cotton Eye Joe?
What's up, everybody? Sort of pre-work on the car check-in here. I've just been around the shop sort of cleaning stuff up and cleaning up the car. Getting ready for the engine to get here. Transmission's here. Quick change is ready. Got my suspension back from JRZ. Fully rebuilt dampers. Everything else should be ready to go. I rebuilt the SLR kit at the beginning of last year, and we didn't do much time on the track. So that should be good. And transmission's good. We had the Rick look that over at RTS. Just need to get my engine back and figure out if I'm going to run dry sump or not. We've been trying to source a dry sump, trying to find sponsorship for it and stuff like that. Had not a lot of luck, so might stick with the AccuSump for next year. Might try and go dry sump, just depending on budget at this point. We didn't really get any sponsorship dollars for this year, so we're still working with the same budget that we had last year, so no major improvements to the trailer or team or anything like that, or the car. So unfortunately Magnuson's new supercharger won't be out in time for the season, so we will be running the old supercharger. So we should have similar power numbers to last year, and hopefully we will actually run this year. So let's go take a look around the shop and let's see what we got going on around here. So I haven't really done much back here. I still gotta get back here and clean everything. Doesn't look too bad, but if you look closely, there's dust all over the place, old oil and stuff, so that area still needs cleaning real well. The interior, still need to pull the seats out and sort of scrub everything down in there, and sort of assess room for a dry sump tank if we do go that route. The engine bay looks so sad right now. Just a couple weights to kind of keep the car steady while it's on the lift so it doesn't fall on me. But yeah, everything else, front suspension all ready to go, cleaned up all this stuff. Everything's all nice and clean. Diff's waiting on us over here. Got our trailing arms over here. Made the jigs for them finally. So we're going to take these apart basically and remake them in the jigs so that they are on point and we don't have to do any weird stuff to get the alignment proper. So yeah, those should be good to go for next year. We're also going to add another bar from this point down to here, because we were getting cracking going on down in here when the adjuster would come loose. So yeah, we're going to have that reinforcement bar up to here to kind of tie the knuckle in a little better, and then probably do like a triangle gusset sort of in here, just sheet metal it up, make that nice and strong. We could possibly even sheet metal up this backside here too, make it even stronger. So yeah, making those a little stronger. We got all our parts over here. Boy, that crank pulley did a number. Just once the crank pulley went, rear main or the front main seal, or rather the front pulley seal I should say, kind of went with it and just shot oil all over everything. Oh, my poor alternator. Oh, God. So we've got a dirty bin of things in there soaking. Got parts up here that need to be cleaned that really shouldn't be soaked, like pulleys and stuff like that. You don't really want to soak those bearings. They got grease inside them and stuff, so you want to just do a quick scrub down with those guys, which I will be doing here in a moment. Other than that, not really much to talk about. Just, cleaning stuff, the really boring part of being a Formula D driver. Cleaning all the dirt off your car at the end of the season. It's not very fun, but very necessary. So, yeah, that's that. I gotta send those axles off. These guys. Okay, those gotta go to drive shaft shop. There's like a 2-week turnaround on those. So, I'm gonna box those up and send those out right now. I'm going to use my suspension box over here.
fresh JRZ coilovers.
Ooh, brand new, rebuilt, no leaks, all seals checked.
Put on the shock dyno. What's he going to be doing good next year?
Shocks will be on point, trailing arms will be on point, front suspension's going to be on point, diff's on point, trans is on point. And hopefully we get that dry sump, and then I can be 99% sure the engine is on point. I mean, you can still break the dry sump belt. There's still things that can fail. There's always points of failure, but I think a dry sump's the move, so we're going to try and do it. And that's about it. So I'm going to get to clean stuff, and I will check back in with you guys once my engine's done. We'll get the engine here, we'll put the engine in, we'll put the trans in, we'll do a cool little time lapse with that, get everything in the car, and do a little dyno video and a testing video, and we're doing a video for these guys too. We picked up CP Carrillo, awesome guys. We've had the rods and pistons actually in the engine since last season, but we didn't actually have official sponsorship because we won them through Southwest Drift, which is very cool of the company to do either way. You know, they gave the championship winner a free set of rods and pistons, which was awesome. It kind of jump-started us on our engine build for last year, and then we picked up comp cans and RHS, and that was it. So, big ups to them for picking us up and throwing us a new set of pistons, because we smoked our pistons last year at some point. Thank you, CP Carrillo, and we'll be dropping a video for them, and then we'll start with the season of FD. Jesus. It comes around so fast. Like, you think you have a break, and then all of a sudden you're like, oh, shit. I gotta put this car together again. So, yeah. That's that. I will see you guys next time. Gonzo. Say goodbye. Say goodbye. Give me a paw. Give me a paw.
Good boy. Good boy. Yes. Yes.
All right. Later.
But I'd been forgotten, I'd been married a long time ago. Where did you come from? Where did you go? Where did you come from, Cotton Eye Joe? But I'd been forgotten, I'd been married a long time ago. Where did you come from? Where did you go? Where did you come from, Cotton Eye Joe?